Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to go over how to import Excel files into PostgreSQL. This will be the best way to just get large amounts of data in here so you can practice your SQL easier and more complex syntax to, you know, return the data that you want. Last video we went over some basic create table statements, insert into, and selecting various ways. And so we're going to get more data instead of manually inserting all that data into our database. We're going to import it. So from the first screen here, when you open pgAdmin, you'll be in servers, click databases, and we're going to go down to tables. We dropped the last table here. So from the last video, so we're going to need to create a new table. So let's open up a query tool just so we can write SQL. But before we get started, so the way we're going to import data into the database is by creating a table, and then you can right click on the table and click import. So we're going to need an Excel file, and if you need a place to find datasets, I did post a video on how to use Kaggle, like where to find datasets and different ones. This is real estate data that I've used in a lot of my past videos for different data analysis tips or just removing duplicates and just different ways to manipulate the data. In this case, this is just a normal Excel file. We're going to need to save it as a CSV file. So in this case, we can save a copy. And in this folder, we can just click Save As Type instead of Excel Workbook. We'll go down to the first CSV file, click Save, and it changed the type, and now it is a CSV file, but in Excel format. So to create a table, we use the same create table statement as before. We'll put real estate data. You can't put spaces, so make sure it's either one word or use underscores inside the parentheses. What we can do is actually just copy these values and then paste them in here. So after each one, we'll put a comma and hit enter. And you can't use state, so we'll use the word states. If it's purple, that means it is used for different syntax and you can't use it. Okay, so now these are all of our column names. So now we just need to put the data types. So we know status will be a varying character. We'll make it 15 long because it's all for sale in that first column. The next column will be integer, and the one after that will also be integer. So we can just put here int, and then also here int. And for acreage, we know that will be numeric because it has decimals. And since it has decimals, we can just make it a numeric value. The next two for city and states will be varchar, a little longer. So we'll do varchar. We'll do 40. That should certainly be enough. So varchar 40. Zip code we know will be an int. Also size, is that a numeric value? It looks like that will also be an int. And previous sold price. So let's just go down to the first value that shows up. So that looks like a date. Okay, so we can just put a date value in here. And then price, we will do int. We put semicolon, hit execute, it returned. And then if we go up to the database, Postgres is the default one. The name, we just refresh. If we click down on tables, this table will show up. If you click columns, you'll be able to see the different types of columns that are here. And so let's close this file don't want to save that. We already saved it as is. And then if we click on the table, right click on the table, we can go down to import export. We will be importing. So we're going to want to choose our file, which this will be the comma separated values file. And that's already the default format. Click OK. And there is a error, and the error will be the very first column. So yeah, that is not an integer bed. So what we're going to want to do is reopen that file. And so after we reopen this file, we're going to just delete the first row. So after we delete the first row, and then just save it, close out of there, and let's re-import. Okay, we can just delete this by clicking here. Let's right-click, go to import. We'll just re-click on the same file as before. Click OK. And the process has completed. So now we can just refresh once again just to make sure it went through. And then if we right click on this table, go down to view edit, all rows, this will select every single row, which is over 100,000 rows of data. You can see that it is all in here. And so it's rows 1,000 of 100,000. So you can go through here. There are null values, which are just the blanks are null in databases. So you can keep scrolling. It'll take us down to 2,000 out of the 100,000. And in the next video, we'll get into different ways to use the select statement to sum values, to group them and order them. But I just wanted to show you how to get your data in here so you can start writing a little more complex things and really work with more data instead of manually inserting it all. And that's all I have for you. Please like, subscribe, and comment. And thanks for watching.